Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicher, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, Nanak Padhi, second coming of Jesus. Only those will know who have Holy Spirit, common sense, and those who are once born men of dead letters, they will never know gospel or second coming of Jesus. Here I am doing a gospel which are sent to me daily by DGO, and here I have rendered the exposition of Matthew 16, verse 11 to 20. It is the Jesus, the anointed, Christ, according to Saint Matthew 16, verse 11 to 20. How could you fail to perceive that I was not speaking about living bread, His word, for the twice born living in Holy Spirit are common sense? Holy Spirit is nothing else but common sense. Holy Spirit with capital S is extraordinary sense, which they possessed at Pentecost. Beware of the yeast of the Pharisees and Sadducees. That was dead letters. They were reading books, as in the university you see them, professors. I have read so many books. I have passed this exam, that exam, but they are all in dead in letters. Because if you write something in spirit, your professor may not agree with you and we will fail you. So they can only teach in the university. Preaching is by grace of our Father. The scriptures read like the novels are by the dead letters. So that is what they were doing. Then they understood that he had not told them to beware of the yeast of bread, but of the teaching of dead letters of the scriptures by the Pharisees and Sadducees. Now, when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his friends and not the once born disciples. Jesus had no disciple except Peter was, you know, who was once born. Of the disciples, Rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, they had disciples. Gamaliel had a disciple, Saul. So Saul did what Gamaliel told him to do, even though it was against his conscience. Who do people say that the Son of Man, Yeshua, is prophet? And they said, some say John the Baptist, but others Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets. He said to them, but who do you say that I am? That is important, you know. Remember Jesus when he was in the temple and there were a group of Pharisees sitting there. He asked the question, you know, whether they know what Messiah stood for. They know the definition of Messiah, so then they can recognize, but they failed. Jesus asked them, whose son is Messiah? That is a tricky question. Messiah is not this physical body, but the spiritual inside. So they answered and told him, son of David. that is wrong. As the university professor, they don't know the difference between Jesus and Christ. Christ is the spirit, Jesus is the name of flesh. And same way the Pharisees do see, they did not know the difference between Christ and flesh. Christ is the spirit, flesh is the, Jesus is the flesh. So, that is, dead scriptures carry no weight. So he said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Now, you know, that is the importance, that what came comes out of your own mouth, that matters. That is, dead scriptures carry no weight in Christ Jesus, as you yourself need to explain what you said or preached. So if you say something or preached, then you have to explain it in detail, not just say that this book say or that book say. That is why Jesus said, do not take any scrip with you when you go to preach gospel. That is why Jesus told his laborers, that they should not take two tunic, shoes, money in their pocket, or scrip, the dead letters of the Bible. Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the Living God. Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven." And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. Now, Peter was a truthful person. Whatever he had in his mind, he would speak it out like a little child, not twisting or anything, no hypocrisy in him. So that's what Peter told him, that you are the Messiah, you know. Then Jesus told him, unless my Father gave you this knowledge, you can't have it. That is, by grace you know it. Peter was with Jesus all the time, but he could not understand gospel. He could only understand the dead letters of the scripture, but not the gospel. But he was truthful, you know, so he stayed with Jesus. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church. Peter means rock of truth. Building on truth is called building on rock, and building on lies mean building on sand. That is why Peter killed two liars, Ananias and Sapphira, because they wanted to enter the church of God with a base or foundation of sand, which does not carry weight there, because from liars, you will get promotion to become hypocrite. And hypocrisy is the chief enemy of Christ Jesus. That's why they killed him, you know, hypocrite at the end. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Kingdom of heaven is different from the royal kingdom of God. Whatever you see with these two naked eyes, this earth, where we live and eat and drink, this is kingdom of heaven. When there is law and order, it is heaven. When there is no law and order, it is hell. Ask these people in Syria where hell is. and they will tell you where the hell is. It's going to be much worse than that. So you should preach gospel for your own comfort and safety. Otherwise, people will kill you. And I tell you, you are Peter. On this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you lose on earth will be loose in heaven. That's why Peter killed two liars, you know, straight away. Then he sternly advised and not order. Jesus came to serve us. He is not our master who orders things. He advised us. Not order the friends and not the disciple. They were not disciple but laborers. Not to tell anyone that he was the Messiah. So this Messiah, that's what I told you, that the Pharisees, Sadducees in the temple, they were talking about it, but none of them knew the definition of a Messiah. So I will take this one up. And Matthew 16, verse 11 to 20. Matthew 16, verse 11 to 20.